Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes for the men's synchronized platform final. Please welcome Ukraine! Double silver medal winners on the 2016 Diving World Series circuit, Alexander Guskomazova and Maxim Dolgov. Please welcome France, represented by Alexis Chandar and Lois Simchek. And now, please welcome Denmark. Silver medal winners in the Diving Grand Prix of Madrid, Andreas Larsen and Martin Christensen. Please welcome Germany. European champions, Sascha Klein and Patrick Halstead. Please welcome the Russian Federation. Silver medal winners at the European Championships, it's Viktor Minibayev and Roman Ismailov. Please welcome Team Italy. This is their first outing as a synchro pair, Mattia Flacchini and Vladimir Babu. Please welcome Belarus. Silver medalists from the 2014 European Championships, Vadim Kaptur and Yohani Kalalov. Please welcome Great Britain. Double silver medalists on the Diving World Series so far, represented by Thomas Daly and Daniel Goodfellow. This is the men's synchronized platform final. Divers, please prepare for your final.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your officials for this session. Your LEN Technical Diving Committee Commission Chair, Georgia Firigu-Consolo. Your Secretary, Klaus DiBiase. The LEN Bureau Liaison, Andre Vlashkov. And your referee, Ildiko Kellerman. Your assistant referee, Hanna Navotna. And your execution judges, execution 1, Daniela Ilyesh, execution 2, Carmen Stridbrook, execution 3, Irakli Bartaya, execution 4, Georgi Chobanov, and your synchronization judges, Syncro 1, Ronald van der Voort, Syncro 2, Nora Sekfi, Syncro 3, Angel Perez, Syncro 4, Peter Axtelius, and Syncro 5, Anna Vianyuk.
So then, this is it. We've had one great final so far. We're looking forward to one more. Men's synchronized platform final. There are loads and loads of people packed inside the London Aquatic Centre, day number 4 of the LEN European Aquatic Championships. And once again, we're just asking for you guys to show your appreciation and to raise the roof for every single one of these teams. No matter where you're from around Europe, make sure you support all of our divers, all of the teams, every time they enter the water. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together in time with the music. Let's make some noise inside the Aquatic Centre and let's get these divers ready for the men's synchronized platform final.
and synchronised platform final about to get underway. Eight teams competing across six rounds, but remember, with synchronised diving, those first two rounds will be a suppressed degree of difficulty at 2.0. So we'll see lots of the classic dives, the reverse, the back dive, the inward dive, and maybe the odd forward with 1.5 somersaults. But the maximum degree of difficulty, 2.0 for these first two rounds. And then we go to the optionals for the final four rounds. And that is when the fireworks will start. Voshkovosov and Dogov then will get things underway for Ukraine. Voshkovosov has already had a dive at this championships, the 24-year-old nearest the camera. And with the darker hair further away, Maxim Dogov. Reverse dive then for Ukraine to get things underway. And our EuroSport diving expert, Chris Snowd, alongside me. You like that one, didn't you, Chris?
Yeah, I like the sound of the entry. This is where we could see tens in this competition because of the entries. They pike at the same time, the same style coming out, so the legs are light, arms around the side, and it's a great dive to start. The divers will be looking to score over 50 points. Anything less than 50 points on the first two rounds is a miss.
Good start, right in there at 51. Ukraine have been brilliant in the majors over the last decade or so. Produced some fabulous divers, and that's a good start. So Alexei Yondar and Loïs Shymatchak of France. Saw Yondar in action in the 3-metre springboard earlier today in the prelims. Didn't make it through to the final, but for Shymatchak, it's his first outing. Inward dive in the pike position for them in round one. And that's, again, how it should look. Drifted a little bit closer together than they would have liked, and quite a lot of splash there from Shymatchak.
Yeah, Shymatchak's closest to us. Could have had a little deeper pike, and then has that small pike just going through the water. So I think it'd be hard to push for 50 points on this. Just not fully stretching out on the end. The synchronization was good though.
But sub 50, which is the mark that these guys are trying to get to with medals on offer. Solid enough start though for France. And for the Danish team, their first diving in this European Championships. You've got Larsen on the right-hand side of your picture, so furthest away. And closest to the camera, Martin Bang Christiansen. Their first outing at this championships. Denmark's first dive at this Europeans. And a forward 1.5 to get things underway. They've been practicing rigorously over the last few days, these two. They won't be too happy with that start, though, Chris.
Christiansen here closest to us as he comes around, lines up too early and drops very short of vertical, so his individual score will be a little bit lower. But Larsen, nice entry, he's going to have a good individual score. Two judges are judging the individual on each of them, so there's four judges and there's five for synchronisation.
Synchronisation was good, and they've not been too harsh on Christiansen for his dive. So nice start from Denmark. Great reception for a fantastic team. This is the pair that have dominated men's 10-metre synchro diving in Europe for nearly a decade now. Eight gold medals to their name in this discipline alone. Housding nearest the camera, Klein furthest away. And it's a case of watch and enjoy.
Well, there was nothing wrong with the synchronisation at all. We see a strong jump into the dive. 1.5 somersaults. Close pipe position, then pop the arms out to the side. But Housding actually has some splash on his entry. But they score well because the synchronisation is up. Housding also with the feet apart. But Klein, a good 1.5.
Well, we'll let Patrick off. He's already dived an entire prelim and final today. He must be very tired. 52.20. They will take that to start their competition. Made a tough stuff, those two. Now, Viktor Minibaev, he of the disappearing dives on the right-hand side of your screen. He'll be furthest away from the camera. Roman Ismailov nearest to the camera. Can Ismailov match Minibayev's diving today. If he can, there's a medal in it for this Russian pair. And a nice start, and straight away Minibayev does what he does best. Great entry.
There was no splash at all. Shmailov, a little bit of splash thrown up. Good here. Excellent pikes. Just a tiny bit out on the synchronisation. Their moves have to mirror each other. Very close there. But Minibayev with the better of the entries. It's going to go over 50 points. Good roll under the water to drag the splash down with them.
And no separating Germany and Russia. 52.2 apiece. So a share of first place in this opening round. The Italians then, Mattia Plachidi and the youngster Vladimir Babu. Babu on the left-hand side of your screen. He'll be nearest the camera when we go to that side on angle, or maybe easier to identify. Plachidi has that massive tattoo on his thigh. Italy then, with a forward 1.5 somersaults for their opening dive. Yeah, it's okay. A little bit of separation, though. You should only be able to see one diver side on as they go into the water. You could see both of them.
Yeah, Plachidi was leaning forward, had his weight on his toes as he jumped, and so he's drifted forward. Babu with the better of the jump, but the synchronization isn't there, and they'll be hammered for it. You've got to be the same distance, and also the pikes were quite open.
Giorgio Cagnotto, having presided over his daughter's gold medal win yesterday in the 1 metre, straight across to give his feedback. He loves his iPad, films every single dive and then plays it back to the diver. It's a great coaching tool that you'll see used a lot in sport these days. Now Vadim Kaptur and Yoheni Koraliu for Belarus. Let's hope Koraliu has recovered from his disappointment earlier. Kaptur's the real deal, we know that, with the black tape on his back, furthest away from the camera, for their opening round dive. Again, forward 1.5 somersaults. No. A great dive. Both men with good dives, but the synchronisation wasn't so nice.
Yeah, Kaptur with the best individual dive. Yeah, you can clearly see that Kaptur just hits the water first. It's good at this point, but the rate of turn is different. They might squeeze a 50, but it wasn't as good as the others.
Legs ended up at about 10 to 12 at one point, which isn't quite there. But they're still into the 50s, courtesy of those individual dives in the 9s and 8s. Very, very good from Belarus. And a real whoop and a cheer from this crowd. Inward 1.5 somersaults in the pike position then for Tom Daly and Daniel Goodfellow to open up. This is one of those medals that Tom Daly doesn't have in the kit bag, and I can tell you that there aren't many that he's missing. Can he do it today? These two have made a very good partnership very quickly. Ready? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, go. Nice start. It's been a while since Great Britain have medalled in this particular event.
Yeah, it's been 16 years, and that was with Leon Taylor and Peter Waterfield back in 2000. So it's time for a medal for Britain.
Brilliant opener, and this could be the lead, you know.
Yeah, this is the best of the synchro from the round one. Tight pike. So the hug the legs, arms pop out to the side, punch for the water, and a classic Tom Daly entry.
Yes, 54-6-0. Daly and Goodfellow lead in the men's 10-metre synchro.
And the end of the first round of dives, and the standings are on the scoreboard for you now. Team Ukraine, back dive piked.
Second round in this men's 10 metre synchro competition. And Ukraine will get each round underway. Hoshkovosov and Dogov with nice dives. Back dives in the pike position. Didn't get into the 50s in the first round, but desperate to get in there now.
Wow, such a powerful jump off the platform. They were piked and then out as they pass the ball right there and just float around for 9 metres. They'll score well.
In fact, they did get into the 50s. My apologies to them. And they're in there again, 52.20 to back up their 51.60 from round one. But remember, first two rounds suppressed at 2.0 degree of difficulty. So only so much progress you can make. But 50s really is the score to be at or better if you have medal pretensions. Now, Jandar and Shimjak. Jandar nearest the camera, but it's Shimjak that looks to be counting. That's a little bit better from the French, but we've still got that separation. Two bodies quite visible as they go into the water.
Yeah, that time Shimjak leaning forwards. Individual dives were good, but the scores for Syncro would just be down a little bit. I like the way they hug their legs, then the hands pop out to the side, looking at the water. Yep, from about 7.5 metres. So the rest of the guys were good, just the Syncro a little bit out.
Still can't make it into the 50s, so mid-40s for France.
Team Denmark with a dive height.
Denmark's entry into these European Championships in the shape of Andreas Sargent Larsen and Martin van Christensen. Christensen nearest the camera. On the side on camera, that is. And again, good rip sound to those entries, but a little bit of splash still coming up.
And you can see that they finished low to the water. Yeah, finally getting the arms back around about 3 metres. Well, they practice a style. That's a Chinese style where you have your hands on your legs there and wait. But loose back going through the water. That's an average dive.
46.80. They will be happy with that mark. Quick look across to the coach for some additional advice. He's been working with them a lot over the last few days in the practice sessions. Now, ever popular Sasha Klein and Patrick Housding, but they have got a challenge this evening. There's a couple of pairs that could give them a run for their money and stop them claiming a ninth 10-metre European synchro title. Second round dive then for the Germans. Inward, 1.5 somersaults. It's beautiful. Great to watch these two.
Yeah, they're spot on. No problem with the entry. And it all started with this jump. They got a little pop up in the air, hug, arms out, line up, and drill the end. See the squeeze of the pike from Klein closest to us. And lines up, arms at the back of the ears. He had the better of the two entries. Housing just a little bit splashy, same on the first dive.
Yeah, it's been a tough day for him, let's be honest. He hasn't quite been as sharp as we're used to seeing. 53.40. But at the moment, living with Klein, and that was a very good dive. So a little bit of pressure put back on the British leaders. Minibayev and Ismailov of Russia looking to build a bit of pressure themselves here. Reverse dive then in the pike position. Just see if Minibayev throws up even a drop of water off the back of this one. Well, there he is, furthest away from the camera. It's an uncanny skill, isn't it, Chris?
It is. Perfect dive there. But Ismailov actually drops a little bit short. So closest to us, you'll just see as he hits the water, his feet drop down. Good at this point. Just synchro fraction out there. Minibayev with a great reverse dive. So his individual score should be higher.
And it's still 50. It is 9.5 for Minibayev for that dive cracker. So 51.60 takes them over the 100 mark for two rounds of diving.
Team Italy back 1.5 seconds.
The Italians, Babu and Pichetti, remain in their same rotation. Divers sometimes switch one side to the other, depends which side they favour on the dive. But the Italians have stayed the same. Barbu nearest the camera, the 17-year-old. And this is an interesting one. Back one and a half with a half a twist. Well, tough dive to synchronise. They both did great individual dives, but again, a little bit of separation.
I like that. They both turn to the left. So here, turn towards camera, pike, and then line up. Hasidi, though, too far out. You just see him drifting away from Barbu. Yeah, very smooth turn. That's good. Again, the synchronisation just slightly out.
Yeah, shame. Nice looking dive from both men, but it's all about synchronisation in this competition. Now, Kaptur and Koraliu. Fabulous dive from Kaptur in the first round. And Koraliu is going to have to try and match him. Koraliu has already dived in the prelims of the springboard competition today. This is a very different demand, very different timing. Kaptur with the bald head furthest away from the camera. And a nice back dive from him. Again, it's Koraliu. He's the diver that will be a little more splashy and will lose this pair marks.
Koraliu loses it here. Just a bit too swingy. And didn't put a knee safe on it at all. So right here, going through the water, he should bend his legs. His legs stay straight. And you see the kick over.
He must have felt he was going there. But body went loose and yeah, no knee save and no 50. So Belarus will stay outside the top three. And once again, this crowd don't need much encouragement here in London to get behind Tom Daly. The leaders after a brilliant dive in the first round. Daly and Goodfellow then with a reverse one and a half somersaults with the half twist that we saw from the Italians. Let's see which direction they twist in. Slightly different and slightly out of sync, I'm afraid. Goodfellow further away from the board, but Daly's dive was beautiful.
Yeah, Daly just had a little bit more snap to the jump, so he didn't go forwards. Goodfellow just a little bit forwards. They turn towards the camera, so turn into the right, then the pike. And it's a shame that Goodfellow just moved away a little bit. Still, it's going to be in the 50s.
Well, Mini Baev and Tom Daly both struggling to fill a teacup with splash at the moment. Good dive for 51. Goodfellow and Daly continue to lead at the end of the second round.
Two rounds of dives completed, and the current standings are on the scoreboard for you now. First two rounds have a limited degree of difficulty, so now we will begin to see the big dives, and they'll really begin to be putting the somersaults in. More fantastic rounds of diving to come. Team Ukraine, back 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists, piked.
Ukraine get the first round of optional diving underway. Back 2.5 somersaults with 1.5 twists in the pike position at 3.2, and that's a great start.
Yeah, quickly into the twist, then pull forward into the pike. Very good form. Just a bit of splash thrown up. It's going to score well. Good synchronization and good individual dives. Sometimes we see feet flying around on the twist. Didn't happen.
80.64, and now we're into the optionals. This is when the fireworks start. Tamara Tokmachova, the Ukraine coach, more than happy with that one. Jandar and Shimjak of France, forward 3.5 somersaults in the pike position at 3.0. So not the highest degree of difficulty, but a tough dive nonetheless. No, they were out of sync leaving the board. They never really got back in sync through the flight, and they were both very splashy on entry.
Yeah, the main problem was the entry. Yeah, a little bit out there. But both of them not really looking at the water. When you come around on the triple, you have to sight the water and then punch for it. So it will be quite a low score. Synchronisation will be okay, but the individual scores, yeah, right down 6.5 and 7.
Yes, would have liked to have been in the 70s with that one, but didn't happen for Alexi and Lois. Larsen and Christensen then for Denmark. Larsen will be furthest away from the camera on that side-on shot. Seems to be the senior partner in this team, even though they're both 17. Well, it seems like they were waiting for the optional round to start. That was a good effort from the Danes.
Larsen had the best of the individual dive. Very vertical, good entry. Christensen just, again, hitting the water a little bit pint. Yeah, he doesn't get fully out of it. Good at this point. Just a little bit out of the synchronisation. Squeezing well. Larsen with a good 3.5. So, in theory, the individual scores will be higher for him.
But better than the French dive. 69-3-0 for Denmark. Well, have you ever seen a pair of divers look more relaxed at the top of a 10-metre platform? Klein and Housding look like they're just having a nice day out in London. They've been there so many times and won this title. They know what is required. Their first optional dive then, back 2.5 somersaults with 1.5 twists. And the challenge continues in usual fashion.
Yeah, now, if we're going to be picky, it was that Klein was maybe 2 or 3 centimetres further out than Housding. But great individual dives. At that time, Housding had less splash than Klein. Sight the water from about 5 metres up. Good twist technique. Locking out the knees in the pike. And finished reasonably high off the water.
Well, they don't match the Ukraine pair. Gorshkovtsov and Dolgov. Just below the 80 mark, but that's still good enough to stay in the lead. They share the lead at the end of round two with the British pair, Daly and Goodfellow. But there's a bit of room to work there for the British duo. Mini Bear finish Meloff. All the pressure on the man nearest the camera when we go to that side on view. The man with the blonde hair, Ishmailov, has to try and live with Mini Bear, who's a genuine gold medal contender. When we come to the final day of diving in the 10 metres individual for men. Oh, we both edged away from the dive there because that looked mighty close to the board, but it was fine.
Yeah, always on the inward. You're never quite sure until that second somersault when they pass the board. Mini Bayoff with the better entry. Ishmailov out here, not fully locked out. And you see quite a lot of bubble and a bit of splash being thrown out. It looked there that Mini Bayoff might have just hit the water just a fraction ahead.
The degree of difficulty, though, allows them to claim 79.68, so exactly the same score that we've just seen from Harsting and Klein on a different dive. Good stuff from the Russian pair. Plakidi and Babu of Italy at the moment in bottom spot. Forward 3.5 somersaults then in the pike position. Again for just 3.0, but this is a really difficult dive to coordinate. They've done it pretty well, but massive splash from both men coming up. So that side of the synchronisation was good if the execution wasn't so special.
Yeah, it's Babu closest to us here, rolls the entry, and you just see the back of his calf muscles catching the water. Yeah, the judges will mark him down. I see the also just a little splashy, but not as splashy.
Just into the 60s with that one, so that's tricky. Not sure they're going to be able to move themselves off the bottom spot if they keep diving like that. Kaptur and Karaliu. I think Vadim Kaptur looks in pretty good shape at this European Championships. dive well in the team event, has looked good so far in this one. It's Karaliu, his partner, that is the less experienced athlete up on this 10 metre. So the pressure's on the man nearest you on that shot. And a reasonable back twister from Belarus.
Catcher, great dive, really good dive. Karaliu, just a small splash being thrown up. Synchronisation not too bad. Perhaps Catcher hit the water just a fraction ahead of Karaliu. Yeah, just that small kick over on the entry. No splash at all from Catcher.
He's looking good. Yeah, good enough for mid-70s, so Captain and Karaliu still in the hunt. Fourth place at the moment. No improvement on where they finished the end of the last round. Now, Tom Daly and Daniel Goodfellow in with 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position at 3.2. Let's see if they can keep their form going as we head into these optionals. Klein and Housding lead on 1.8528 after three dives. And they will have the British pair for company. Brilliant stuff.
Well, Goodfellow, I reckon, had the best inward 3.5. Great entry. Tom just a little bit out with his hands. Yeah, there's a lot of splash for Tom. Technically, though, perfect dives. Good out together. And a little bit of splash from Tom. Unusual for that. But there's a high degree of difficulty. It'll be a big score.
What a good contest we've got on our hands. 81-6-0. Daly and Goodfellow wrestle the lead back from Klein and Housding, the champions, by just 1.92. That's pretty good diving from both teams. And Hojkovasov and Dolgov of Ukraine just hold off the Russian challenge with Minibayev and Ismailov. That's your 1-2-3 at the moment, with three rounds of diving still to come. Looks good. Well, still a number of variables could happen here tonight, but this fantastic crowd in the London Aquatics Centre once again being entertained by some high-class diving. And once again, looking at the possibility of gold for the home team. Ukraine, though, in bronze medal position at the moment. Their fourth round dive, inward 3.5. Oh, that is beautiful. They were under pressure because Goodfellow and Daly did it so well.
Dolgov, I couldn't see anything wrong with his dive. Just disappears. Oh, it's going to be a big score again.
Into the 80s in round three.
And I think this will score more than Tom and Goodfellow's.
And then right into the 80s in round four. 85-4-4 for a total of 269-88. And first place for the moment, the Ukraine pair ramping this up nicely. And they dive first, so they get to put the pressure on the rest when it comes to that final round. Alexis Gendar then will be nearest the camera. And his partner, Lois Shimjak, furthest away. The French with their fourth round dive back 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position at 3.3 on the degree of difficulty.
Oh, what a dive.
I wasn't sure that Gendar was going to get away with that, but he has.
He certainly has, and it was that he just caught the water right on the inside palm of his hand. Good synchronization, strong kick out, a little bit bendy in the back, but the entry was phenomenal. Kick, reach, tighten up, knee save under the water. Spin in, spot the water here, kick. Oh, great back 3.5.
Big score coming. Oh, it is a great score. 85-1-4 then for Gendar and Shimjak. And that'll do their case a lot of good. Welcome to the final, boys. The two 17-year-olds from Denmark, Larsen and Christensen, trying to stay with the pace that is being set. Inward 3.5 for them then at 3.2. They've got some reasonable degree of difficulty through these final three rounds. And that's a reasonable dive, a little bit too much splash, unfortunately, this time from Larsen.
Yeah, and he slapped the water there. He was upset, diving furthest away from us. Yeah, he kicked out too early and couldn't drive the legs up. He needed to change direction and do a scoop if he had any chance of getting in straight. Christensen, again, just missing the reach back around the ears, so he kicks over on the end.
66-24. The two juniors, that's still good scoring. They'll be more than happy with their performance so far in this final. Klein and Housding, what have they got in store for us in this fourth round? Back 3.5 somersaults in the pike position, which takes that degree of difficulty to 3.6. This is a dive they'll be looking to put pressure on with. And they will put pressure on with that. Brilliant from the Germans.
Again, Klein, his entries are spot on. Diving furthest away from it, I can't see anything wrong with the back 3.5. Housden just out a little early and needed to pull around a bit more. I think this is going to be the highest scoring dive so far. High DD and Klein, a near perfect back 3.5.
Oh, they've smashed it. 92.88 in the fourth round for Klein and Housding. Look at that. Business as usual for those two. Just chatting away like it's another day training down the pool. Germany then with a very strong lead at 278.16. Who is going to respond? Mini Baef and Ismailov outside the medals at the halfway point. But for their fourth round, this is a big dive. Forward 4.5 in the tuck position. Oh, the camera operator couldn't quite keep up with them there. They were flying, and if they'd been a little tidier on entry, then that would have been a really big score.
Yeah, Ismailov misses his entry. He shook his head as he got out of the water. Strong throw, good at this point. But Ismailov, although he went over, hardly any splash. Yeah, more splash there from Mini Baef. Just caught the water wrong with his hands.
Well, very unusual for Victor. But still into the 80s, but you can see by the look on Victor Mini Baef's face, he knows that just isn't going to be good enough for medals if the other pairs keep diving like they're diving. In with 3.5 somersaults then in the tuck position. 3.2 the degree of difficulty for this dive for Lachidi and Babu. Babu nearest the camera, the younger of the two Italians. Ooh, that was a little bit close. Flat feet, poor entry.
Yeah, you can be marked down if you get too close. Babu, though, missing his entry. Yeah, a little close for that hair. There you can see. I wonder if they actually hit the board with his hair. He's going to be marked down for that. We'll see two low individual scores.
He almost falls out of the dive, doesn't he, after that?
Yeah, he's going to be marked down for that. So the first two scores that come out would be lower.
Yes, they are. 5.5s. So 65-28. The Italians will continue to prop up the bottom of this final. Now, Captur and Coraliu. They're reasonable dive, as I said in the last round, managed to garner 85 points. They are still in the hunt for a medal, these two. Fourth round then for them, forward 3.5 somersaults. No, Captur dropping very quickly. It was a great dive from Vadim on the far side and a really good entry, but there just wasn't the synchronisation in that dive.
Yeah, whatever happens at the start causes the, well, you can see Kaptur didn't jump as high. Amazing entry though. I think he's going to get a big score. So score 3 and 4 will be higher. Yeah, because of the entry, you see that just disappears.
Should be 8.5s at least. Oh, he's 9s. Great dive from Vadim. But that synchronisation score just not quite there. So 74-70 for Belarus. The pressure's on once again. It's going to happen each time Klein and Housding hit their dive. Tom Daly and Daniel Goodfellow are going to have to at least try and match it, which means on this occasion going into the 90s.
Yeah, they need 91 points.
Reverse 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position then. It is possible. Oh, it's good. It's a good dive, but not sure it's going to quite be into that 90 zone.
Well, this has a degree of difficulty of 3.4. So the maximum score you can get is 102. They need over 91 points to take the lead. It's going to be close. They might get it because of that entry. Look at that.
Yeah, the individual quality of the dives might just save them here. If the judges go with it, we've still got a close contest. And we have. It is 90. 91.80. And Tom Daly and Daniel Goodfellow maintain their lead by a fraction of a point. 0.84 of a single point is all that separates Great Britain and Germany as we head towards round 5 of 6, with Hoshkovasov and Dolgov still doing their job and holding off the challenge of the Russians, Minibayev and Ismailov. But Daly and Goodfellow lead here in London. Well, without doubt, Chris, the synchro competitions here at this European Championships have provided us with the real entertainment.
Yeah, it's world class. And I think it's because it's Olympic year. Everyone's ready. We've got the qualification spots. And we're just 3 months out.
The biggest dive then on the list for Hoshkovasov and Dolgov of Ukraine. Forward 4.5 somersaults in the tuck for 3.7. Just a little short, unfortunately, from Hoshkovasov, but Dolgov found a good dive. And we'll see if that's good enough to keep them in bronze.
Yeah, they might just not quite get into the 80 points. Oh, poor entry. At that point, the synchronisation is good. Well, that might save them. The synchronisation scores will be good. Just missing on the individual. There's the roll under the water.
Well, it's where they need to be in the 80s to keep the pressure on. But they'll both know that they've left a couple of marks in the pool there. So Ukraine pair will have to wait for the Russians to dive to see if that score of 350.91 overall is good enough to stay in bronze medal with one round to go. Now, how well did Jean-Darc Jimjac of France dive in the last round? Brilliant effort from them. Now they go to their highest tariff dive. Reverse 3.5. Shimshak counting it out. Long hold. Oh, no.
Synchro's out.
Well, that was a shame. That really was a shame. For whatever reason, there was almost like a double count there. Jean-Darc didn't say, no, let's go. He said, no, I'm not ready. And they went again, and they were completely out.
Yeah, Shimshak is ahead. That's just miscounting. And then he knew he's blown it on the synchro and then just kicks too early, can't pull the dive around. Jean-Darc actually twists on his dive, so a disastrous... Yeah, that was 3.5.
That was a real case of do we go on 3-2-1 go or do we go on 3-2-1? Whatever the plan was, they got it wrong. 55-08. Yeah, they're just explaining to the coach, Shimshak, saying, look, I said to Jean-Darc, this is where we're going. But all the training these guys do, that should be routine. A miss for France then. Larsen and Christiansen for Denmark. Addition of some pink tape to Larsen's back. Let's hope that's not a problem for the youngster. Two 17-year-olds going reasonably well here for Denmark. Oh, and again, they're just struggling controlling the end of the dives, and the synchronisation is generally good, but the judges won't take a good memory away from the finish.
Yeah, Larsen holds on to the tuck too long and kicks over. Christensen, the same thing. That's the problem with synchronised diving. You're concentrating on the start rather than thinking about the dive. You know, you want to go at the same time as your partner, and so it's an extra thing to think about. And if you're not experienced, then it takes a while for your brain to kick in and work quickly to get the kick out.
So just short of the 60-point mark this time around. Well, it's not just the German team that are shouting for Klein and Hausding. They are a very popular team. They've dived brilliantly so far. Reverse 3.5 somersaults then for them in round 5. They've got a big dive to come in round 6. And they are a long way off. The synchronisation for them, nowhere near as good as it normally is, and two poor splashy entries.
Yeah, Housden really rushed his arm swing there, so he's ahead of Klein. Klein, again, with a good reverse 3.5. They're going to be... Look at that synchronisation, completely out. And Housden, again, with a heavy entry. Klein, world-class reverse 3.5.
This could be really costly for the German pair. Oh, it is 78.54. We're talking about a potential for a 10 mark swing here, depending on how well the final pair, Daly and Goodfellow, go. Back to the battle for bronze at the moment. Minibayev and Izhmelov, the Russians, just down on Hoshkovosov and Dolgov. But good dive from Ukraine over the last two rounds. They've kept their noses in front. Back 3.5 then in the pike position. High tariff again for Russia. Oh, what a shame. That was beautiful for the first two-thirds of the dive, and then Izhmelov got his out wrong.
Yeah, he pushes the feet towards the platform rather than up in the air, and then arches his back. He realizes just as he's coming out, he's out too early. Look at the synchronization, fantastic. Minibayev, really good, back 3.5. But that's a very poor out and entry from Izhmelov.
Costly error from Izhmelov, 74.52 on a dive that if he'd hit it would have been comfortably into the 80s. And he's looking a little disconsolate there. A lot of pressure on the less experienced of the two divers in these synchro pairs. Always difficult. Now, Babu and Plakidi, they've been entertaining. They just haven't been entertaining the judges, unfortunately. Back 3.5 somersaults for them then in the tuck position for round 5.
Oh,
and again, trying to splash as much of the crowd as possible, I'm afraid, Plakidi.
So the jump's good, spinning well. They're not uncomfortable there. But Plakidi, yeah, just hangs on too long. Maybe he missed his spot. Babu with a kick over as well. Synchronization fine, just untidy. And almost hanging on for a quad.
54.45 then. And the Italians will remain in bottom spot. Belarus next to the board. Fifth position at the moment. Inward 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position to come. Vadim Kaptur furthest away from the camera with the necklace on. Has looked really good. Looking forward to seeing him in action on Sunday, in our final day of competition. Now, can Koraliu get it right this time? Yes, yeah. Koraliu can. It's actually Kaptur that throws up the splash, but overall, that was a good-looking dive.
Yeah, I was checking to see Kaptur was close or not. Just
now,
seeing.
What's, the problem here with, I'm hoping that he's just holding his head.
Yeah, no, it's the entry. He's hurt his head on the entry, not by hitting the ball here. His hands break.
Got you.
So the head caught the impact 37 miles an hour. That's why he's holding his head.
Well, he peeled a bit of his skin back a few years ago when he caught his head on the board in a horrible accident. Vadim Kaptur, he's come back from that well, and that explains why he's holding that part of his head. It's exactly where the scar is, actually, from that diving accident.
Yeah, but he's okay. 2011.
Yeah, a while ago now. Now then, Daly and Goodfellow. Here we go again. Forward 4.5 for 3.7. This is the dive that will underline their position at the top if they get it right. Oh, it's a good dive. The synchronisation a little out, but, you know, they're going to be okay here.
Well, they only have to go 77.75 to go or keep the lead. So, Tom, great jump off the platform. But Goodfellow is travelling forwards and the synchronisation is out. But because of the high degree of difficulty, I think they're safe. Individual scores for Goodfellow will be lower than Tom's. Tom's is worth about 8.5.
82.14. The gold medal is still very much within their reach. And I can tell you that has increased their lead over Klein and Housding to 4.44 points, which in the context of this competition is actually a reasonable cushion. But they're going to have to rely on a very good dive in the final round to hold off the challenge of the Germans. Poshkovasov and Dolgov have managed to increase their lead over Minibayev and Ismailov by 22 points. So a little safer in bronze. We're into the medal dives straight up in this sixth and final round of the men's 10-metre synchro platform competition. Back 2.5 somersaults with 2.5 twists in the pike position for Hoshkovasov and Dolgov of Ukraine. 3.6 the tariff. If they get this dive right, then they will have booked themselves a medal and they'll have to wait and see which colour it's going to be. And Chris, that should be good enough, surely.
Oh, they did have a buffer over the Russians. 10.23, though, behind Tom Daly. Good twists. Just a little bit out on the synchro on the end and a bit splashy. It's a shame about the entry there.
Dolgov's leg's a little strange here at the end. Judges might have picked that up. And 78.84. Keep an eye on that score. 4.29.75. That's the important score at this stage in the competition. Will that be good enough to hold off Minibayev and Ismailov for the bronze medal? Will it possibly get them something a little better? A little shinier. Shondar and Shimzhak have flattered to deceive on occasion. Unfortunately, got their count completely wrong in their round five dive, and both went off at different times. Let's hope they can sort it for this sixth and final dive. Back 2.5 with 1.5 twists for just 3.2 on the degree of difficulty. Well, it's definitely Shimzhak, isn't it, that's kind of going away quickly. Seems very rushed away from the platform.
Yeah, just a poor takeoff, leaning here. Furthest away, and he's about half a metre out further. Shanshard looks well at the water, so he's got the best of the individual dives. It'll be in the 70s, but that's not an 80 dive.
No, 74.88, but solid enough to sign off in this final for France. And time now for Denmark to finish their competition. Andreas Sargent Larsen and Martin Bang Christiansen. It's Larsen, slightly taller of the two, that's furthest away from the camera. He takes all the counting duties. And and a nice forward twister to conclude their competition. That's the best of their dives, I think.
Yeah, they're less than the best for last. Usually the divers like in the final round to have the safest dive, the best dive that they can relax on, not try too hard. Good double twist. Synchronisation was fine. Larsen perhaps a few centimetres further out from Christensen. Oh, good effort from them.
Should be a good score as well to finish, which is always nice to take away from the end of a competition. Yeah, that's better. That's much better. 74-5 then for Denmark. And a little wave to the crowd. They've enjoyed themselves today. They've worked hard for that opportunity and they've taken it nicely. Here we go then, the battle for gold. Germany's Sascha Klein and Patrick Hausding with a back 2.5 somersaults with 2.5 twists at 3.6, their joint toughest dive, and looking for a 9th gold medal in this 10-metre synchro discipline. Well, first job is to get past Ukraine on 4.2975. They should be fine.
Yeah, they'll do that. I thought actually Hausding closest to us, a little close to the end of the board. Yes, very close with his elbow, but drills the end. Oh, he's lucky he didn't touch there. Klein, just a small kick over on the end. Oh, waiting for this score.
And the mark is set at 4.45.26. 88.56 for the dive. And that little discussion between the two German divers suggesting that they're thinking, OK, there is some space for Daly and Goodfellow to work. We'll work out exactly what they've got to score, but Daly and Goodfellow are still going to have to hit a big dive. We'll bring you up to date on that in a moment. Let's just take a look at this bronze medal challenge from Mini Bayer and Ishmailov. They've got the degree of difficulty to do it. Back 2.5 with 2.5 twists, same dive as we've just seen from the Germans. And if they hit it, they might just be able to squeeze past Ukraine. Oh, it's a great effort. It's going to come down to the judges.
Yeah, big DD. I just thought that both of them were just a fraction short of entry. Fast twist, 2.5 twist there, pull forward into the pike. Yeah, both about 5 degrees short of vertical. The synchronisation, though, is spot on. Just there, just missing out a little bit on the entry.
4.2975 is what they need to get themselves into what should be bronze medal position, and they haven't done it. 87.48. For 4.26.51. It's not over yet. There are still some variables out there to account for. But at the moment, it looks unlikely that Russia will take a medal away from this competition. Right, before we get back to the battle for top spots, let's see Plakidi and Barbu's finish. Reverse 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position. Kiedy counts it out. And again, a rather staggered start to the dive and a horrible splashy finish.
Yes, yeah, Barbu right down on his back. He would have felt that. A little bit out here, but Barbu, you can just see that. Almost a backdrop. I think it was more of a guess. His head is up in the tuck. Placidi over slightly, but it doesn't really matter at this point. Big miss on their final dive.
Not happy. Understandable. They will finish in last place, Italy, as we go to Captur and Coraliu. And then it'll be Daly and Goodfellow to see if they can prize that gold medal out of Klein and Hausding's hands. Fifth position at the moment then for Captur and Coraliu. They've got a 3.4 degree of difficulty on this reverse 3.5 somersaults in the tuck position. But this would have to be perfection. Complete silence in this pool. And And I'm afraid that isn't going to be good enough. Capture and Caraglio, both of them missing their dives in the end.
Caraglio just kicks out too late. The jump's good, safe, not too close with the heads as they pass on the second somersault. Capture squeezing well, like his tuck position. Even he has a small pull over. There's Caraglio, who misses the entry.
So Belarus won't threaten the podium. 72-4-2 for 395-28 finishes their competition. Fourth place at the moment, but likely to drop to fifth. And Chris, here we go. Tom Daly then, and Daniel Goodfellow with a back 3.5 somersaults in the pike position. What have they got to score for gold?
84.13, and they can do it. It's a 3.6.
Great Britain missed out on one goal by a fraction this evening with Jack Law in the 3-metre springboard final. And now Daly and Goodfellow with a second shot. Oh, it's a great effort. Tom Daly's dive was quite brilliant. A little wash over from Goodfellow, but the synchronisation, Chris, was excellent.
Yeah, I think they may have got it. Tom, perfect back 3.5. Squeezes. Well, there was no splash at all from him.
Listen to that, the crowd listening to these marks as they come out.
It's going to be really close.
It's going to be a medal, we know that. But is it going to be good enough for gold? This is going to be mighty close. 4:45.26 to beat. No. Oh, 4:44.30. And Tom Daly, so close to a second gold, but it's his first ever medal in this discipline. He'll be pleased with that. It's a second silver for Great Britain this evening. But Germany get to celebrate. Another gold medal for them, and it's a second gold in the 10-metre synchro after Van and Cujo picked up the gold the other evening.
I know, the Germans are looking great. But I have to say, I was watching Tom. He didn't miss a dive at all. It was just a shame. Goodfellow at the end, just a little over on that, back 3.5. Otherwise, they would have pipped the Germans.
But Klein and Housding make it 9 golds in 10-metre European synchro. Congratulations to them. Brilliant performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's 10 meters synchronized platform final. Presented by CEO of European Aquatics Championships 2016, Tom Chambers. Gifts will be presented by UK Sport Head of Finance, Sophie Dusutoy. Winners of the bronze medal, Ukraine. Presented by Alexander Goroshkovazov and Maxim Dolgov. winners of the silver medal, Great Britain! Represented by Thomas Daly and Daniel Gunther. Winners of the gold medal and Len European Aquatics Champions 2016, Germany! Germany were represented by Sasha Klein and Patrick Halstein. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Germany. Show your appreciation for our medalists. Victory ceremony for the men's synchronized platform final. Bronze for Ukraine. It's silver for Great Britain. But Germany have won themselves the gold medal tonight. Well done to Klein and Halstein. That was the combination that took home the gold for them. As they make their way off the podium, ladies and gentlemen, can we ask for a big round of applause for all of our medal winners tonight here on night number four of the Len European Aquatic Championships right here inside the London Aquatic Centre.